Good afternoon, everyone. My name is David Lord. I work as Blended Learning Lead at Heatherwood and Wexham Park Hospital. And when I got the chance to take part in this project, developing apps for mobile devices, thanks to the SHA and Helen, to be honest, the reason why I took part is I was absolutely clueless about mobile learning. I have never owned a smart device, couldn't even access my address book in my mobile phone, which I don't have anymore. And to give you an example of how clueless I am, or was, or am, I got issued with a BlackBerry from work last Thursday. I left it on my desk. It started to ring. It rang until my colleague said, "Aren't you going to answer that?" And I had to look at him and say, "I don't know how." I am now having lessons from the apprentice in our office, and I can now answer my BlackBerry. I can't make a call on it yet. That's next week's lesson. But that's where I came from. But everybody was talking about it, and talking about developing apps, talking about commissioning them. It was being mentioned in our trust all the time. And as Blended Learning Lead, I knew I had to learn a bit more about them. And actually developing one myself, or at least trying to, seemed a very good way of actually learning about what was happening. We had a project. There's a leadership development project going on in the trust. And I knew the subject matter expert. Now, although she's very keen on face-to-face, she's not a fan of mobile, she's not a fan of e-learning at all, but she could see value in it for initial knowledge transfer and as a sort of refresher aid memoirs. We were initially going to look at initial knowledge transfer, things that people would have to read before they actually came to any of her sessions. But when we looked at the BlackBerries, which were issued to management staff at our trust, we thought, well, is anybody going to sit there for 20 minutes reading a document through the BlackBerry? We have no evidence of the contrary, but we felt that that wouldn't probably, it's not something I would want to do, and it's probably not something we felt that they would want to do. Research might prove me wrong. So we went instead for the idea of aid memoirs. Now, the SME I work with refers to a great many leadership models in her training. She'll ring them off one after the other on different topics. And to be honest, most of the time you remember it. If I hear it, I think, now what's that again? And we figured that having a little sort of almost electronic pocketbook on leadership models would be really useful for people. And on a mobile device like a BlackBerry, which people carry just about everywhere, having said that, I've forgotten mine today, so I prove the exception to the rule, it's very handy. They could just pick it out, hear a model mentioned, want a little more information on it. It's there at their fingertips. And basically, we came to the conclusion, one thing that's good about GoMo, we felt, was its branching abilities. Because I wanted to get away from linear learning as well. The idea that we have to start a course, work our way through it, and finish it, seems to me a little bit outdated in many respects. It's, to me, something we've inherited from the classroom, where you've got 20 people in a class, you have to start at the start, cover everything, and finish at the finish. But I did feel that, you know, we felt that basically for this anyway, it's just a reference. You don't want to start, you don't want to finish, you just want to get people to look at exactly what they want to look at. So while there'd be an introduction showing it, there'd be an index at the end giving a list of all the modules, so if they weren't sure which section it comes under, they could find it in the index. But generally, there'd be separate categories, and with the models, they do fit nicely into different categories. So if I considered team building example, there's various models here. I have to say, this is very much a work in progress at the moment. There are a lot more models we need to add to each of these, but it gives an example. And I don't know if you've heard of Belbin's 9 team roles, but the structure of the description of all the models would be consistent. We'd start with a little introduction, as short as possible, a diagrammic representation of the model, which might explain everything that somebody needs to know. If that's it, they just go back. They don't need to explore any further if they don't want to. But there'd be hotspots on the diagram. So if people wanted to look up the thinking roles, for instance, they could click on that. The subscreen pops up. You get a list of the thinking roles. You can see which ones, what they involve, what they're about. And if by some chance you want to know a little bit more about the background of the model, there's a little extra stream there which you can go and deal with that. So the whole thing, we reckoned people could go through all the information that's encapsulated there in about 3 minutes. We figured that's probably all people would want to use that. It just acts as an aid memoir. We'd also have some references at the bottom for more academic texts. So if people did want to learn it in depth, they could actually go and do it. After they finished, they'd return back to the team roles in case they wanted to look at any of the roles again. But next click would take them back to the initial team building list as well, so they could look at any other. As I say, it's basically still a work in progress. There's still a lot of work to do on it, but that's the idea we had, and it has given me at least a good idea of what's involved in mobile apps, even though I haven't got a clue how to download one. Are there any questions?